true friendship between Jesus and us.
Yeah.
He says that ye are my friends. He said, if ye do whatsoever I command you, henceforth I call you not servant, but I have called you friends. Like when you just said something regarding how a Christian life is, you said sometimes some people see Christians and say they're suffering, you just pray and fast, like just say being a servant to Christ, you know. But we are more than that, because this passage clearly says if we do whatsoever God commands us to do, he has already called us his friends. It's, I feel like it's a blessing to be a friend of God. You're a friend to someone who knows everything, a friend to someone that knows your future. Like, and the only thing we need, I keep insisting on this, the only thing we need to be closer to God is the ultimate intimacy. You need this private time to know him more. Like even in the and in the book of Genesis where it says sometime God comes and walks in the cool of the day when Adam and Eve were created. Around that moment, you need to go somewhere far away just to be with God, just to understand. You just want to hear the sound of the birds and the water and the trees and the wind blowing just to hear him speak. He's going to come to you. And you sometimes we don't even understand the love that God has for us. I'm saying this because it's taking me this long to realize that it's only God. Only God that is my friend. It's only God that nobody else. Even when I'm running away from him, he keeps fighting. I don't think we have any friend on this planet Earth that will keep fighting for you even when you're at your worst. That's why we come to realize at one point that we are all alone and there is nobody. I'm saying this because sometimes we depend on people so much to a point that we don't even see ourselves. When we look at the mirror, we see other people in us, and without them, we can't live. So we have to realize that because God lives in us, you can't consider another human being to be your image. You have to consider God as your image because he created you in his own image and his likeness. So each time you're going astray, come back and say, God, I know you live in me. And because you live in me, your presence never disappears. You always fight for me despite all my iniquities. So